hardly a voice at all.
Do that because I may have to come back and get some stuff.
No, don't take that baggage.
Hal, Earl, I'm taking these. I'm not going to be living here anymore. And that's why I'm taking the suitcases.
Set, Doyle. Just leave the big bag with the rest of the set. Lord, this is so you.
Here's your suitcase.
You guys are gonna be all right, and I'll see you sometime soon. I don't know what else to say. Oh, I can't put it into words.
Back on the stage of the state championships, the night at last revealed itself as not just any night, but as the night. The night when it all began. Ben Wechselbaum, the best voice to ever debate for PHS, Plainsboro High, according to anyone who ever heard him. That, Ben Wechselbaum. He just went quiet.
Our next advantage basically says that human relations can only thrive in an atmosphere of total equality. That human relations can only exist. I'm sorry, I just said that. Wait.
Six miles apart, at the very same moment, all the arguments stopped. So there was this bridge of silence spanning New Jersey. No shouting from Hal's parents, no debating, no voice, no one's voice at all. That year's national debate topic was farming subsidies. And if you don't know how farming subsidies could inspire all this commotion, then you don't know life. And there's nothing that can be said about it. Suitcases and marriages and farming subsidies launch cataclysms. Can a voice travel from one person to another? Like yawning or mono? Sure it can. That's our position. But the will to speak traveled that night across the dark New Jersey highways. Until it arrived on this very block, where it would take up residence, or try to, in someone new.
Gnome de plume sound right? It sounds right to me. It was toward the end of the reading that no one seems to have completed. Open your books to page 248. Let's do the reading that should have been done last night.
Finish the pizza.
Yeah, I'll have a pizza.
Fish or pizza?
Of the,
The pizza's plain or pep. Fish is not sure. A general fish.
Yeah,
the fish?
The general fish. Yes,
please. Come back for seconds. Plenty left.
Thank you, ma'am.
Fish or pizza?
Pizza.
Do you want to keep on trying the breathing exercises or something new?
Is it all right if I don't have an opinion?
Let's try this. I read in this journal, Clinical Pathways to Speech Pathology, that it's hard to be anything but fluent when you whisper or sing. I sent away for a videotape of some people trying that out. Not a solution, obviously, but want to give it a shot.
I can't do this. Isn't this too stupid, Honoria? Even for Honoria, this is too stupid. I can just feel it.
I explained this, Hallett. This is not my speciality. I'm sorry. I'm trying. It's really a shame that you're not hyperactive, because that I know well. That I can work miracles with. Hyperactivity. But back to breathing. Yeah? Breathe. Good, come on.
It was 1858, and while Senator Stephen Douglas set out his case that states ought to choose whether to allow slavery, Abraham Lincoln consulted with the smart citizens of Illinois to plot his answer.
Lincoln's a check.
Let me find now a citizen to assist me in coming up with arguments against Senator Douglas. Where can I find such a citizen helper? The commoner in the striped plum-colored shirt. We need you, sir. Rise to your duty.
Get up there.
Yes, mommy!
My assistant has come to offer me arguments in my debate against the senator.
Ha! Now I'm quaking.
What cannot a house divided against itself do? It is this argument that will lead me to victory. What cannot it do?
Hold it further away from your mouth.
What cannot a house divided do?
Mr. President, house divided can't.
Some help from the citizenry.
It can't stand.
Oh, I thought it was shit itself.
Thank you. How about a round of applause for the good governor?
Ladies and gentlemen, which you have listened to Mr. Lincoln during his hour is.
You look taller on stage.
Agnes. I'm trying not to listen, okay? Distinctly not to be. You're one foot away, so just...
Do you want to hear your problem? You've no agenda. Strictly head in the ground material. Look at me. I wake up every morning and what do? I create an agenda for the day, which is a sub-agenda for the month. Which is in itself a pie slice of my agenda for life. Do you want to hear my purpose for today?
I can assure you that I absolutely do not.
Probably call the cops on me anyway.
Hey, Adolf, switch his name. Up to Daisy.
This is my seat.
Like all seats on this vehicle? Yours has been paid for with taxpayer money, which means that I or anyone else has just as much right to it as you do. In fact, given the distinction between what your family surely pays in taxes and mine, I think it's safe to say the seat is substantially more mine than yours. Do you see now? I'll be taking just a minute to talk to the little man, and then you can go on borrowing my seat for as long as you like until I want it again, right? Coach Lumbly with the pilgrim hat. She teaches patterns of adult living. She's on her third husband, the name of Wallace Lumbly, Wallace the Third. It's a particular pattern she doesn't lecture us on in class. Anyway, she came up to me after a presentation on egalitarianism and said that although my argumentative skills were at the fetal stage, She sensed, somehow she intuited my potential, and she invited me on the team. So now here I am 2 years later doing the same thing with you. Recruiting. Ferreting out the debating talent from the masses. That's you. I've ferreted you.
You mean public speaking? Like speaking in public? Yeah, no, I don't think that's not very...
Resolved that the federal government should support the teaching of abstinence in public schools. From sex. It's a big step up from farming. That was last year's resolution.
Yeah, no.
Suit yourself. But deformed people are the best. Maybe it's because they have a deep resource of anger. It serves them well. Were you trying to say thank you? I thought you might be stuck trying to say thank you. You're welcome.
I'm sure this is awkward for the boys.
Not one bit. Not one single bit. I swear I'm more nervous than anyone.
Honestly, Jules, I'm a small claims judge. It's lucky I'm not dating someone from Trenton.
Is this some traditional Korean dish? Because it has an exotic odor.
That's tuna casserole.
My dad hasn't dated anyone before your mom for 6 years.
Can we just not talk about that?
I got this by a tree stump in the park. Look at this one.
Fire!
Then on a Thursday. It could have been any day, but it wasn't. It was Thursday. For no good reason, something happened. And it was like a little wave breaking over him.
Again?
And it said the name. G-I-N-N-Y. Ginny. The wave said the name, Ginny. Over and over. Ginny, Ginny,
fire.
Ginny.
0 points, Hal Hefner.
Ginny.
Here we go. Rising Earl 3, the effects of early sexual relations include transmission of diseases, out of blood pregnancies, and it was potential illnesses. Consider contention 1, early sexual relations. Participation in the voting is 52% more likely to yield positive results. Now, the other thing that I wanted to tell you is that you even look like this guy is to debate with, in a shorter, goofier kind of way. And what would you be doing here, looking enough like this guy, if it wasn't for me to discover you and what talents are hidden within?
Hi.
Resolved that Hal Hefner should really stop letting the world tell him what's possible and try and figure it out for himself. Maybe that's a life's philosophy suited just to some of us who cherish winning. So maybe it's not for you, but I think that it is. The quality of life among teens who are frantic, KTWR, is anecdotally higher than teens who don't take KTWR. We need to turn to the one that's from Mount Hoskia for it.
Before this, there was the nothingness of Plainsboro, New Jersey. But now Hal Hefner suddenly had only one thought. And it felt like all his life his brain had been waiting for this thought. So comfortably now did it fit in and take up all the room there was.
You're on my street. You're still on my street.
Do you have any idea what public property is?
We'll see. Says it's public property, and if it's okay with your mom, you can come up 7-Up with me. But the ice maker's busted, so...
couple work on their marriage through some music therapy?
I'm upstairs.
No thanks. Not today.
I have a request in for binoculars for my 12th birthday, so we'll see about that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who is that?
Beats me. Hey, do you know if she wears a bra? Wanna see a bra?
Yeah, I should really probably go home now, Lewis.
Okay.
Judge Pete, Your Honor, do you know any lawyers, great lawyers, who can't talk very well, not fluent, but yet great lawyers, whose clients don't end up getting the chair?
Oh, there's a bailiff with a prosthetic leg.
What do you think, Laverne?
Hi. I talked to Mrs. Which is it anyway? To the coach, and I'm gonna come inside for debate prep now. Thanks to you.
Someone took something of mine. I had a locket. I had a 24 karat gold deco locket with two pictures inside. Is this ringing any bells? One was of me. The other was of someone else, a boy of sorts.
It's a deco.
My mother believes that one of her pseudo-friends stole it because he or even she is secretly a pedophile and wanted the locket to stare into or suck on or utilize for other specific erotic purposes. But I told her that I have this hunch, I have this womanly hunch that it was taken out of my backpack by someone at PHS. It's like I sensed it leaving my presence, just an ounce, but a burning ounce as it left my person.
Well, I don't think that the pedophile thing could be true. Not that I even really know anything about that, but I just don't believe that anyone would really think of you like that.
Like what?
Sexually, I mean.
That's the worst thing anyone's ever said to me. I can't believe you said that.
No, I didn't. No,
I never should have asked you to join the team. God only knows what I was thinking.
But I didn't. No. I stole it.
Shouldn't you be at school?
Oh, you weasel ass! You let my dad pop this shit-faced mess! Don't ever touch the stuff I steal! I mean it! I steal it, it's mine!
No, you really put that on your business card. It's someone's
hand. Now you're gonna tear in your heart, you fake thief! You got off a make-believe thief! Judge Pete's gonna lock you up! Get your own mother effing plan! If you tell anyone I sold, I'm gonna wipe my ass with your chapstick. I'm gonna reach in your eye sockets and tear out your pancreas. I'm hiding my death box so you'll never find. This is ridiculous.
Stay up.
right, Abel.
Is this the Hefner Mansion?
Yeah. Can you hold on for a second? I'm just gonna
move. But stay on. You can hang up now, Earl.
You can hang up now, Earl.
Oh, okay. You're the boss of me.
The boy whose picture I keep in the locket that you stole, did you see him?
Yeah.
His name's Ben Wexelbaum. We debated together.
Until he freaked out at the final round at States and left me with a lousy second-place trophy. I've never felt anything like that. Have you ever felt like you could burn the world down?
Every day.
Well, he dropped out of high school, and then we never did have the decency to call. I heard through the grapevine that his grandmother got him a job at the world-renowned Louis Dry Cleaners in Trenton.
I don't think that I've ever heard of it.
Right. Anyway, ultimately, it's a good thing that the spirit of cowardliness overtook Ben Wexelbaum, because it is, one, left my partner arrangement free this year, and two, allowed me to find someone that I can mold into the kind of bare-knuckles debater that I want to debate with. The best debaters are the ones with something to prove. By trying to rise above the fiasco of last year at States, and you trying to prove to the world that you're not as retarded as you sometimes sound. Which is why I want you to overlook the embarrassment that comes with having taken my locket and join up with the team after all.
You're on vicious tonight, Virginia.
I'm on an important phone call is what I'm on.
You're on an important call in the world of Virginia Ryerson.
I have to go. I'll see you at my house on Saturday. You're helping me with research. Yeah.
Oh, Ginny, are you still there?
Oh, I am, Catherine, yes, and it's a good thing I am.
If you think you're going to get a long-term girlfriend without my permission, you got another thing coming. I'll never sleep safe again, not ever. Don't do it, little shit. Don't do it.
Try not to steal anything if you can.
Cut it out and come inside. Close the door behind you. Sit down. You're finding the quotes in the affirmative.
So, what do you believe when it comes to abstinence?
Top debaters never really believe in anything. It gets in the way of arguing from both sides.
But I mean, like, for you, like, in your own life.
Debate is life. You shouldn't think about it in any other context.
Because in my mind, I don't really think it's a very good idea. Because I just don't think it's a very good idea. Not for kids in New Jersey.
Okay, well, that's enough tangential bullshit. Write down these template arguments against abstinence. One, supporting it violates the barrier between church and state. Two, it's an enforcement of a dated sexist agenda. Three, sexual freedom is the basis of human freedom. Four, it separates us from Western cultures, Europe in particular, when we should be drawing closer to our international allies. Five, psychologists say that repressed sexual functions can create adult neuroses. Six, abstinence programs actually increase risky sexual behavior among teens. Seven, it creates barriers between free love generation parents and their more conservative children. Eight, and finally, we oppose abstinence because the world might end, and then basically everyone we know dies a virgin.
Wow. Yeah, all those, when you think about it.
In preparation for our first official debate exercise next week, show me that you can argue in favor of abstinence.
Well, I think I may be better arguing from the other side of this.
How?
The only one that I could really come up with was that love is, it's more special when you do find it.
The special love case. Probably that thing, but I'll think about it some more and we'll see.
Dad says he and Mom have done every one of these at least twice, and some as many as 100 times. But he says no one's keeping count, which seems like a big waste, because he could be the Kama Sutra Barry Bonds or something, and no one would even know it. Yeah, I tried this one with my pants on Winchester, our old dog, but he once sat still, and he died a month later.
Thank you.
Interested in joining my club, the Junior Philosophers?
My plate is kind of full.
I know what you're thinking. We read everything, but no Hegel, if that's your concern.
No, actually, I'm waiting for a girl. That girl.
Once I was your age, just as quiet on the inside as most of you novice debaters are. Quiet as a mouse. Or a stone. Or a bowl of pudding. And then I saw my first debate, and the pudding was no more. None of you novices understands me now. You will. Until then, the thing to remember is there are rules that must be followed. That's debate. And that's life. Our exercise today is an accelerated run-through of a complete debate round to teach you those rules.
Why is the Hal Hefner bowl of pudding allowed to demonstrate to us?
He's first year, that's true, but Miss Ryerson has assured me that he is a quick study and a rare talent, and he will instruct and enlighten us today. Our debate begins with Jenny, the first affirmative, delivering an 8-minute opening speech. For our purposes, Jenny will synopsize that down to 10 seconds.
Good afternoon, ladies and germs. Our affirmative case today, in effect, states that increasing teenage pregnancies will eventually bankrupt Social Security, destroy the economy, and result in the Third World War. Therefore, we will quadruple the federal spending given only to schools that teach abstinence to their students. Thank you.
That was lucid. Thank you. Now, there's a 2-minute cross-examination. Second negative to first affirmative. Crystal Hamish Steinberg is the second negative. Crystal Hamish Steinberg, would you give us an exemplary question that you would ask?
Have you ever heard of Bangladesh?
The perfect tease. Now, the women may sit while the first negative rises to respond to Jenny. Philip?
Rather than attack the affirmative case, Crystal Hamish Steinberg and I propose the following negative counterplan. We grant all the harms claimed by the affirmative, but state that the better way to combat teenage pregnancy is by pouring money into a huge rock concert that we'll call the Concert for Sexlessness.
Thank you. Now the first affirmative cross-examines the first negative.
Do you have statistics on how many rock stars practice abstinence?
How many rock stars at the historic concert for Bangladesh for Bangladeshi?
I'll ask the questions here, Philip.
The combatants sit. Now Hal Hefner wows us with his second affirmative. Another 8-minute speech boiled down here to 10 seconds.
There were 3 immediate lines of argumentation that came to mind, but the best one went like this. The plans are not mutually exclusive. Increased funding for school programs doesn't preclude the negative team's badly named Concert for Sexlessness. The government can and should do them both. Hal Hefner visualized himself in that moment as the kind of kid who can state, the plans are not mutually exclusive, whenever he wants to say so. The plans are not mutually exclusive. The plans are not. No, they aren't. They are not mutually exclusive.
Handling Hal Hefner's cross-ex and rebuttal until the first actual debate tournament at Hazlitt against other actual schools. Until then, he will be my silent partner. Hal Hefner, sit down. Do you know what I sounded like the first speech I gave when I was your age? Ben told me I sounded like a Bob Dole impersonator.
I'm not even really... I'm not even quite sure who that... It even is.
That was your first try. Your first of many. And I don't even think anybody really noticed. It wasn't that big a... So, we should get back. Well, I should get back and finish the round, so...
That the federal government should support the teaching of abstinence in public schools.
Resolve. The mother effing federal government should support the teaching of abstinence in mother effing fucking public schools. Resolve.
Do you know how you or one would take a relationship to the next level?
I'm glad you came to me because
This is exactly the sort of problem that mommy and daddy would royally screw up. See, it's all about having an agenda, which they will never tell you. If I'm playing like today, I'm getting a blowjob, and it helps you to realize it. It's all very scientific.
Mm-hmm. I'm just a doubter. They're giving me a PJ. It's high on Jenny's list.
You're her partner, right? So you wait until the moment is right. The gift you crack a good, a really good joke, like the one that I crack about the Queen of England, and then ask. It's totally worth the risk, and you never know. Once you've had a blowjob, you don't understand. It's like walking through a brick wall.
You know, Jenny said that I won't be her real partner for months, and that until then, I'm like the mascot, the disfluent mascot. The disfluent mascot who's not getting a BJ.
Aardvark.
No, that was a joke, Heston. There is an Aardvark bait mascot.
I, for some reason, was convinced it was an Aardvark.
No.
C'est la vie.
Hey, I wanted to try this joke out on you. The delivery is kind of tricky. So, what happens is that the Queen of England goes into this television show and
listen.
It's like,
I'm almost done with this chapter. It's Thomas Aquinas. But if you continue telling me that filthy joke, I'm gonna put this book down and punch you very hard.
You know, someday you'll find love and then. Then everything will be different.
Masturbation is a natural precursor of adult sexual development and should be unfettered in a child's learning. Jellison, 98.
Her plan's changed.
Virginia says to keep on working hard and she'll call you to let you know when you should come on over.
Well, because the Hazlitt tournament is almost here and...
Just keep on keeping on and maybe she'll call you.
Hi there.
Do you know if Ginny Ryerson is okay? Because she canceled her time today and we have a big tournament coming up at Hazlitt High School, and all the major Jersey schools will be there. She hasn't really told me what her strategy is going to be to help me deal with my speech.
She got into a Lincoln with that Indian guy.
And you're back. Is Jenny all right? Because Lewis Garland's from across the street said she got into a Lincoln with an Indian man.
A boy, that's right.
But she's fine?
Fine.
Will you just tell her that I'm done and over with the masturbation defense? Tell her that. Will you just assure her that I'm done with masturbation and I'm ready to show her?
You take care now.
I told Judge Pete about all the fun you've been having with debate, and guess the news? Heston's a joiner.
It's too late, Heston. The teams have all been settled.
Coach Lumley said that after the first tournament, someone always gets creamed and never comes back. So I'll be filling that slot, whomever's that may be.
To discover opportunity in misery. There's sense in that.
That's how I found you, my love.
Hello, Connie Ryerson speaking. Bertram, is that you?
This is Hal Hefner I'm calling for G-I-N-N-Y Ginny.
Hold the line.
Hi, Ginny. It's Hal. Hey, Hefner. What's up?
Hal.
Yeah.
She says she'll see you at the debate tomorrow, okay?
Okay. Well, I really need to practice with her.
She'll see you then.
Hello?
Good morning, Judge. Good morning, your esteemed opponents. Let's begin with our plan. That the federal government should...
Shut the mumbling, Susan. But do not stop working, because if you fail tomorrow, the whole Hefner family fails too, and I am not a failure. So do not do it.
Good morning there, Judge. Good morning, our esteemed opponents.
When you work so hard at something, so hard, all that extra time, Wallace, you always tell me balance out, balance out, balance out.
What are you talking about?
Jenny Ryerson has transferred to Townsend Prep for the rest of her senior year. We have an even number, so Hal, you muddle through today with Heston, and we'll reconstitute the teams tomorrow. Let's go, Wallace. Would you like to tell me what our affirmative case is? Or would you rather it be a surprise?
Good morning there, Judge. Good morning to you both. You are esteemed opponents. Good morning. Resolve that how much time, timer?
Hello?
Mr.
Well, what's the matter?
Well,
it's funny that you ask, actually. I'm just here at Hazlitt High School at the debate.
And I spent the last 7 minutes of my Roundland speech trying to see the resolution.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Well, there's that video I gave you, singing instead of talking.
Yeah, did rat poison the straw come with that video?
Well, my ex-girlfriend, the PhD at Annenberg, she used to say her brother never stuttered if he spoke in an accent.
You can try the accent you know best, and maybe that would help.
Well, anyway, I wouldn't count on it. Mina's advice was about as far-fetched as she was. You know, open relationships just don't work, Hal.
What?
I'm advising.
That you should try to do an accent, okay?
If I do that,
you won't see me on Monday. Because I'll probably be on a plane to... Can you hold on for a sec?
Okay, I should probably go.
Good afternoon, esteemed opponents from Glenrock. Good afternoon. Let's get out.
let's get down and dirty, shall we, with this thing I'll call our plan.
Excuse me, I'm really sorry.
Slice of pizza or sloppy joes, and I don't want to debate you on it. Slice of pizza, sloppy joes, and I don't want to debate about it.
I'll have the
Brata pizza. Sloppy joes are all that's left, but they're not that terrible if you've never had really good ones before.
Thank you, ma'am.
Do you love me, baby? Do you love me, baby? Do you love me as I love you?
She's not here. Ginny and I don't need a tournament. Just blood from the brain.
Or do you hate me, baby? Do you hate me, baby? Do you hate me as I hate you?
To do here.
Well, this is the girls' room, so.
Okay.
I want to read also what one judge wrote about Virginia. She wrote, "Virginia may be the next Barbara Jordan." How about that? First place individual speaker, Virginia Ryerson.
Stay a moment, would you?
I'm gonna regroup.
Let's be adults here and think about who could use a little time on the sidelines.
Ginny, recruited me. Okay. She intuited that my brain was made for this. I mean, you can't even ask me a question without my brain filling up with retorts. It's full of retorts.
Do you know Minto Buru, who doesn't speak more than 6 words of English? Or Evie Swiderski, who has such pronounced irritable bowel syndrome that she's being studied by a team at Princeton?
No.
What about Elvis Hunsinger, the boy who pees himself in gym class?
Well, everybody knows Elvis.
She tried to recruit them all. Never crossed my mind that this could be some scheme of hers, but when you think about it, it looks pretty bad.
I need someone, a person to talk to, someone who cares and love. Could it be you? Could it be you?
Your mom's running late, but wants us to.
Hey, now. Wait a minute. Let me see. Oh, Jesus. Man, oh, man. The most Heston ever hauled in was an honorable mention in the hip-hop dance-a-thon. But this is too much coming from you on behalf of your dad. This goes on the dining room table for your mom to see when she gets home. Woo!
You got to kiss off into the air. Behind my back, I can see them stare. They'll hurt me bad, but I won't mind. They'll hurt me bad, they do it all the time. Yeah, they do it all the time.
My dad told me I was the world's utmost idiot for not realizing you want something today. Please accept my belated congratulations.
I hope you know that this will go down on your permanent record. Oh, yeah? Well, don't get so distressed.
Hello?
Hello, Sylvia.
Two for my family, and three for my heartache, and four for my headaches, and five for my lonely, and six for my sorrow, and seven for no tomorrow, and eight, I forget what eight was for, but nine for love, God, ten, everything, yeah! Lungs kill soft into the air, behind my back, I can see them stare, they hurt me bad, but I won't mind, they hurt me bad, they do it all the time.
There's a cello in your house now.
There's pineapple cake in the fridge. If you're late, but I'll eat the whole cake, so it won't be late. Maybe you should put the whole debate thing behind you. Ooh, a lark of adolescence. We all have them. Mine was cheerleading. I was the one boy on the cheerleading squad. Imagine that, huh? Give me a H, Give me a A, Give me a L, What does that spell? How?
That image is not really helping.
Just because debate was a wipeout, I mean, you know, a colossal wipeout, doesn't mean that you're a failure. It's the activity that failed you. Hey, there's nothing to say you couldn't try for the Spanish club. I mean, you could be Spanish club vice president in no time.
Kyle Filowitz is el vice presidente.
Yeah, my point, Hal, is that you have to get out of your own way here, man. Go back to living the way you were before you tried to exceed your limitations.
Hal Hefner floated above his life, saw the world around him as if he were just a ghost floating through. Nothing could harm him now. Nothing could move him or make him love again. He was that kind of ghost, the kind that couldn't love again.
Go to observation 1A. Conversion is the norm.
blood, he said before, the root cause of sexual dysfunction of any good Virginia Patrice and her cousin of Dallas.
As a boy ghost, Hal Hefner surveyed the world as he knew it. And in everything he saw was evidence that life goes on, with or without love. He had stopped thinking about the girl. Had stopped dreaming about her. Or even if that wasn't entirely true, had stopped dreaming a certain kind of dream about her. Well, maybe most of the time. Then spring came, 11 months after his father left. 6 months since he last saw Ginny, and 6 since they kissed.
That's according to her. She said that it was all her, that it's always all her. And could we be buddies?
Relationship.
Yeah! This is why your dad left. You're just so messed up. Mama! Oh.
Virginia Ryerson, please come to the main office. Virginia Ryerson, you have a visitor in the main office. Are you her little brother? You look like you could be her little brother.
I'm her ex-lover.
Take a seat. She'll be with you in a minute.
So how far did you get with her?
Does it count as second base when it's groping through the shirt?
Maybe in public school.
What are you doing here?
I have spring break at Plainsboro. I have the day off.
Okay. I'm going back to AP Latin now.
I'm returning this to you. It belongs to you and. And it's important to me that you have it. It's your Hazlitt trophy. I had a bad night, but I'm better now.
I don't want the trophy. I'm gonna go back to class. You need to leave.
Everybody has their own path.
Security, please report to the main office. Need you to deal with a stuttering boy in the main office.
It was like he was pretending. Pretending that it could all be what it was, but it can't. You can only pretend for so long before the forces that be take that away from you. Just like that, it took off, and he found himself sprinting. It was ridiculous, but he did. He sprinted. You don't let love collapse all around you and not put up a fight. You punch back. Unless you can find someone else to throw the punch for you. Then, by all means, do that.
Yeah? I'm here from Plainsboro High, and I've come here to find you.
Wait in the front if you care to. My shift ends on the hour.
Well, I care to.
Yeah, well, that's fine. Wait in front.
That's God doing your dry cleaning. God does dry cleaning. He wears a smock.
Man, it's a blessing to be squarely and dearly out of the goddamn suburbs. Suck the marrow right from you, the suburbs will, and it takes years in the big city to inject a life back into you. Literal years.
Wait, you mean the big city is Trenton?
That's right. Trent.
Oh.
Did Jenny send you?
Oh, no, she doesn't. She doesn't know anything.
Lumley?
No.
Because if this is part of a grand design to get me back to school, you smell the bus exhaust? That'll be what you leave behind on your way back to Plainsboro without me.
Wait, the thing is that what I need is your help.
You don't even know me.
You do realize you're like a legend of PHS, right?
Right, I'm the next Shelley Hasty.
Who's she?
He supposedly drove a Chevy Nova into the cafeteria in 1986. There's a plaque somewhere next to a water fountain in his honor.
Well, I'm gonna be the next legend at PHS. And that's not gonna happen for me any other way than to win at States.
You're gonna win at States.
Yes. Well, we are, yes.
It's so pointless. That's the realization I came to at States last year. Life is nothing but repetition, the same thing, over and over. Somebody might give you a trophy, and that's supposed to mean you're making progress, but there's no such thing. The fights you fight today are the fights you fight until you die.
Yeah, well, be that as it may.
Sure. Be that as it may.
Wait, it's not some college application bullshit that's like the driving force here, or any bullshit.
I'm sure.
Want to know what it is?
Yeah. What it is...
What's up? Or if it's not that, then it's the need for revenge when love goes bad. It's one of those two, love or revenge. I'm not really sure which one, but it's one of those two things that made me throw a cello through somebody's window, so you figure it out.
An actual cello?
I mean, like, yeah, like, symphony size, as far as I know.
You know, that's pretty sharp in my book, as far as reasons go.
I took a bunch of throws, but, you know, I'm good for a bunch.
Have I got this right? Your contention is that we should debate as a team. You, an inexperienced kid with a bad and unpredictable stutter. Me not having debated at all this year and having no knowledge of the resolution. In support of this, you basically offer up that you threw a cello through someone's window. It's charming, no question. It is a persuasive. Why not make the case that A, allowing me to return to States and win this year will tie up that loose end so that I can forge ahead free from any of life's regrets. B, that charitable enterprises such as this would be the lifeblood of advanced civilizations, even perhaps especially in places like Trenton, New Jersey. And C, that while this life here is infinitely preferable to the wretchedness of the suburbs, it's also not quite what I must have had in mind. And maybe I missed some of the mundane thrills of policy debate.
Yeah, I mean, all of that.
This goes against my better judgment. It does. But what we'll need is one affirmative case and one all-purpose negative counterplan. We can't do a year's worth of work in 1 month, so we'll concentrate on those two lines of attack. You'll have to arrange with your parents. Do you have parents?
Oh, yeah, I have a mom that I see most days, and I see my dad some weekends.
You'll have to come to some arrangement with them, or else let go of trying to, so that you can spend evenings and weekends here. We'll register as a homeschool team. My grandmother will sign whatever official paperwork is required. But all such considerations weigh on our priority, and that's finding you your voice.
Suddenly, Trenton was a different city. No longer a dead end, but a starting place. Trenton, the very city of triumph.
Fire when ready!
This isn't very good for one's spirit.
I can't hear you!
It's spirit crushing, I said. Fine. What should I say?
Give me your standard affirmative opening!
Yeah. You know, I haven't really said it enough for it to be standard.
Throw me the cello!
Let's get down here.
It's a riddle. What it is one of those rare instances where one of us having an advanced college degree might actually help.
I won't whisper. It's a trick, but it's crap. It's a crap trick. and I won't do an accent, however good I may be at them. So that's just leaves. That's just singing my speeches, and after that arranging to have my ashes scattered over the Plainsboro Municipal Pond. You know, I've thought about the singing, and I don't think I can do it, the song thing.
This is the battle hymn of the Republic. I might prefer something more modern, I realize, but this is the only piece I can play all the way through. What you're gonna do is just learn the song well enough to keep it in your head, to let it flow through you as you speak, sing your speeches. We'll write to fit the rhyme. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He is trampling out the vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He is loosed the fateful lightning of his terrible swift sword. His truth is marching on. You think our case will state that sex is bound to be explored.
Absence is the catalyst.
Read first.
Absence of the catalyst to support such a far-ranging platform. We on the affirmative need it by... Go away. That's Dad's.
Thought you could use a bigger suitcase. One with an actual handle. I swear, Penelope, I don't know what you would do without someone in this family who can steal and then organize.
Can I have a request, Earl? If I win today, could we say that you'll stop calling me with girls' names? Can we say that if I win?
Let's not push it, shall we? Besides, Penelope's my favorite girl's name.
All right, well, could we maybe just leave it with Penelope then?
Yeah, we can do that.
Thank you, and welcome to the 43rd Annual New Jersey State Debate Championships. There are 22 schools represented here from every region in the state. Every preliminary round through the semifinals will take place in the classrooms in the adjacent academic buildings. You'll only return to this auditorium at the end of the day for the final round and the presentation of the trophy. Now, before we begin, I want you to give yourselves a big round of applause. That's right. Now, pairings for the first three rounds are randomized. Then they're weighted by win-lose record.
This is my favorite brief of the year. It says that abstinence leads to a global crisis in mental health. Aren't you that Chinese boy?
Korean, yes. Just so that you're aware, it's really ignorant to lump us all into one category like that.
You all can't win, but you are all winners. Good luck to you.
I think our case will state the sex is bound to be explored, that adding funds for abstinence is what I will have roared. But such a case has been heard so much that we are bored. Our plan is thus not that. Our government can best support teaching abstinence by refraining from their common and ugly arrogance. Instead of telling us we should never do the dance, they should adopt this plan.
amend the Constitution so that no one over 20 can serve in government. There'll be only kids aplenty. We'll write the laws and fix it, and it won't cost a penny. That's our basic plan. What we'll do is create a new federal government where teenagers are the only voices of authority. By doing so, we'll help create a wider consensus among teens. It's a more democratic system, and democracy is the very basis for love, as we'll argue below in the rest of my song speech. Now please turn to contention one of our plan. Now this one's a little harder to get the rhyme scheme for it because of all the quotes that say have sexologists in them, which doesn't really rhyme with too much, but it basically goes like this. the role of the sexologist.
Gentlemen, come with me. Ben, Marcia. The bow tie, the pretty boutonniere. Yes, sir, it stirs the pot a little.
For me too, Coach.
No, don't do that.
Excuse me, Coach. I'm a minute into my opening, and I'm killing in there. Aren't I killing?
I've heard worse.
She's heard worse.
There was an objection raised to your entering here today, and the New Jersey League officials have already voted on it, and it doesn't feel altogether great to have to tell you this.
You're not homeschooled, Mr. Hefner. And working most days at a dry cleaner's, Mr. Wetzelbaum, means that you're not either. You've been barred from the competition. You're welcome to stay and observe if you'd like.
You know, might have actually won the whole thing.
Probably not, if you really apply powers of reason to it.
So that's it?
Come visit me sometime if you want. We'll reminisce about this, what it means.
Today was not my day, okay? But someday will be. And on that day, you will be sitting at home alone. At home. And you'll think to yourself that when you're alone that I knew him when. Him being me.
Anarchy is not only the best system in which to encourage adult maturation, it's also the best system in which to encourage sexual liberation. Don't you dare go thinking that this was easy for me or simple. If you think that my feelings on the matter were clear, then you'd be underestimating my complexity. And while I see that you don't recognize this now, you actually have me to thank. In part, modesty forces me to acknowledge, but in large part, for your newfound zest of competition and gamesmanship. That was very clever of you to find, Ben. Surprisingly clever and very painful. Which means that I upped your game, little man. You're welcome. Liberation breeds liberation. Sexual freedom inspires political freedom, and the heart of all liberty is the liberty to engage
Why do you leave with a stranger when I am revealing my heart? Because I love the unknown. I love the unknown. He said he loved the unknown. Because I love the unknown. I love the unknown. He said he loved the unknown. They asked him, hey, where is this bus going? And he said, well, I'm really not sure. Well, then how will you know where to get off? And he said the place with the most allure. Because I love the unknown, I love the unknown. He said he loves the unknown. Because I love the unknown, because I love the unknown. He said he loves the unknown. Because I love the unknown, I love the unknown. He said he loves the unknown. Because I love the unknown,
because I love the unknown. I will have you can imagine it's not fish because you don't have any fish here. At least I hope not. That's good.
But I'll have a slice of a slice of the pizza.
You can pay me when you're through.
You know, why don't I make it not one slice, but I'll have not one.
I'm gonna close up in a bit.
Why don't?
Just take all three. Otherwise, they're getting trashed.
Thank you.
Eventually, all of this would pass, and the memory of it would give way to embellishment and fantasy and outright distortion, until it was hard for Hal Hefner to remember what he was really like back then, when he still carried in his head the sound of a made-up perfect voice, the voice that can speak its heart, the voice he used to wish he had, until the day he stopped wishing he sounded like anyone else and just started talking as he was.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm okay. But listen. What are your thoughts on love?
Oh man, it's so late, Hal. I couldn't find the off ramp and ended up circling back three times. And I don't even know if I know how to get you back to Plainsboro.
You know, it really shouldn't be rocket. Sometimes, I don't know, I guess I just wonder when it all starts to make sense, you know?
Oh, what?
All this, you know, everything.
Oh. Well, I guess there comes a point. See? When you reach a certain age, and you're in Jersey, or someplace just like it, and you stop trying to figure it all out, you just are glad for what you have.
And that just, like, happens for everyone?
Yeah, pretty much. But you let me know if it turns out different for you.
I'll do that. I'll find a good way of letting you know how it all works out.